My dear students, today we will learn a new chapter, that is Introduction to Synfig Studio. Let us see. Students, in this chapter we will learn regarding Synfig Studio, features of Synfig Studio user interface, creating a new file and saving a new file. So let us see, what is Synfig Studio? You can see this image. What does this image means? It is a 2D image. Okay, 2D animation created by using a drawing illustration. Okay, images drawn on each sheet is called a frame, and many such frames form a frame by frame animations. Okay, so an animation can be defined as a rapid display of sequence of images to create an illusion of movement. Okay, and those animations will be, we can see. So time-based animation tools are used to create animation with less time and resource by employing different techniques in the preparation of characters in an animation. So those animations could be created using some applications such as Synfig Studio, Pencil 2D, Adobe Animated CC and Director are some of the examples of time-based animation application. So one of this application we will study, that is Synfig Studio. Synfig Studio is what? It is an open source 2D vector graphic and timeline based computer animation program. This was created by Robert Quattlebaum and Adrian Bentley in 2005. Okay, Synfig was released as a free software under GNU. What is GNU? GNU is a general public license which is available on various operating systems like Windows, Linux and macOS operating system. This application is time-based multimedia or threading tool. Application is known as what? A multimedia authoring tool. The element in this application are organized along a timeline. You can see this software is basically used for creating the animation which has a proper beginning and ending in the message. Synfig uses two techniques, namely morphing animation and cutout animation, to eliminate and need to draw each frame. Okay, what do you mean by morphing animation? Morphing animation means it is a special effect in animation that changes one shape to another through a seamless transition. And cutout animation means what? It is a form of stop motion animation using flat characters or photographs. What all are the features of Synfig Studio? There are many features which is available in Synfig. First, it is possible to design the animation both in front-end and back-end. Quality of animation frames can be prepared with fewer people and resources. The program offers an alternative to manual tuning. What is tuning? Tuning means it prevents the animation from drawing multiple frames, and it simulates soft shading using curved gradients within an area. Radial blurs, color tricks are some of the real-time effects that can be applied to layer or group of layer. It can control and animate the width of lines at individual control points, and it can also be used to link any related data from one object to another. You can see the interface, complete window of Synfig Studio. This is the complete window. This is the workable area. Here are the tools being available. Okay. And these are the tools which are available in Synfig. Okay, these are the pen, this is used for cropping, this is the text, okay, this is used for selection. These are the interface which is available in Synfig Studio. Now, there are some of the toolbox being available which contains system buttons, tools and much more. These tools are used to create a new file and set up properties. Toolbox consists of general tools like circle, rectangle, transform for creating and editing an object. Canvas. What do you mean by canvas? Canvas window is seen at the center of the application user interface. The working area is known as what? Your canvas. Okay, a timeline can be seen at the bottom. See, this is the timeline which can be used for at the bottom of the window. Different frames in an animation can be switched between by clicking on lock and unlock frames. Okay, next is your panels. What is the panel? Panel contain the tools and information about certain elements of the project. There are specific panel of specific set of features made available in the application. This is the table which describes about different panel which is available in Synfig Studio. First panel name is Canvas Browser. This panel shows the tree of canvases present in the currently selected project. Canvas metadata panel means what? This shows all the useful existing keys that these units used in the panel for guide X, guide Y, and grid size keys are of the system Synfig units. See, these are the grids. These are the grids being available. Okay. So for this, the Canvas metadata panel is used. Graphs panel. This panel displays the parameter of the currently selected function of time. In history panel, you can see the history of the data or the actions being used, like you have cleaned the file or not, or undo, redo options are available. Info panel is basically used for the information of the current cursor location on canvas. Also, it displays the current RGBA or color picker value of the cursor position. Keyframe panels, this is used for the animation can be made, and keyframe is the starting and ending point of any smooth transition in an animation. In layer panel, you can see or view or edit the layer hierarchy in an animation. In library panel, you can see all the value nodes or all canvases in a current animation, like all the working data is being available in library panel. In navigator panel, it is used to for the position, or it says the position of the working area. Palette editor is used to add outline color of the palette. Parameter panel is the heart of the Synfig interface, which is used for data, or describes the data about the type, or it displays a simplified time track. Okay, next, time track panel shows a symbol for every waypoint in a timeline. Now, next part is how to create a new file. You need to follow some of the steps for creating a new file, like select new command. Then you need to click on properties. Then you need to select this image size, that what image size you want, and then click on apply. The specific changes in the canvas is being applied, and then you need to click on OK. By doing this, you will find that the particular file has been opened. Then you need to do all the editings in that, and then the last step is your saving the file. How to save? You need to click on choose save command, and then it will allow you to save the animation in either of the three format, like compressed Synfig, uncompressed Synfig, or container format file. It also allows the user to save the file in the current version of the early version of Synfig Studio. Any of the file format you can choose, and you need to save your file. By doing this, you have saved your file and you are ready to work on it. So thank you, student. This is all about Synfig Studio. I hope the topic is clear to all of you.